In this illustration, we'll analyze the elongation of an accelerating rod. We are given that a uniform metal rod of density rho, length L, cross-sectional area A and Young modulus Y is moving on a horizontal smooth surface with a constant acceleration A naught. We are required to find the stress at midpoint of the rod and elongation in it. Now, in this situation, we can analyze it by considering a rod placed on a smooth horizontal surface. Say, if I draw the picture, this is considered to be a smooth surface on which a rod is considered, and say an external force F is acting on it due to which it is accelerating with acceleration A naught. Now, we are required to find the stress at midpoint of the rod. So, at midpoint, if we divide the rod in two parts, this left half of rod and this right half of rod, both will be of equal masses. And in this situation, we can consider the two parts will apply a tension T on each other. Now, if we apply the Newton's law on the left half of rod, you can write for left half of rod in figure, we write equation of motion, and this can be written on left half only one tension is acting which is responsible for the acceleration. So, we can write T is equals to, we can write its mass as M. So, this will be M multiplied by A naught, and mass of this half of rod will be its volume multiplied by density. So, this can be written as rho multiplied by cross-sectional area multiplied by L by 2, which is the mass of this left half multiplied by A naught. So, this giving us the tension at the midpoint, which is half rho A L A naught. If we calculate the stress at midpoint of rod, then this stress we can write as tension divided by the cross-sectional area, which will give us half rho L A naught. This is one result of the problem. And we are also required to find the total elongation in the rod. We can reconsider the rod now. To find the elongation in rod, we consider a point at a distance x from the left end, and we consider at this point the tension acting is say T on the left part of the rod. And this T is responsible for acceleration in the length x of this rod. So, we can write the equation of motion for a length x of rod as shown. Here we can write T should be equals to its mass, which is density multiplied by x multiplied by A multiplied by A naught. So, this should be the tension, and this implies if we calculate the stress over here, the stress will be T by A. So, at this point x, if we are calculating the stress, the value will be rho x A naught. Now, here we can say if dy is the elongation in element of length dx, here we consider an element which is of width dx over here, then we use strain in element can be written as dy by dx, and we can further write the Young's modulus of rod is equals to stress by strain, and here it can be written as stress is rho x A naught and strain is dy by dx, which on simplification gives us the value of dy, that is equals to rho a naught by Young modulus multiplied by x dx. We can integrate this term to calculate the total elongation in the rod, which is integrated from 0 to y, and here it is integrated from 0 to L. So this is giving us the final result as rho a naught L square by 2y. That is the result for the elongation in rod.